Citation generators are really handy ways of grabbing a citation and dropping it into your document, but it's not without problems, and I want to show y'all a couple of the common problems and remind you that you need to pay attention to how the citation is supposed to look and then edit your citation accordingly. So I am doing a citation for the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention website, and this is an article on a web page that has no author. It does have a date here, updated February 25th, 2020, so I can use the date, but it's a no author. So I have used a citation machine to copy and paste the URL of this citation into my citation machine, and here is what it has put out for me. So let's compare this now to what is listed on Purdue OWL, which Purdue OWL is a great source for checking your citations. They have a lot of examples and you can see what it's supposed to look like versus what yours looks like. Okay, so I'm under Purdue OWL. I am trying to do an APA citation, American Psychological Association. So now I'm looking for the citation that most looks like the one that I'm using on the page. The very first example they give here has an author's name and mine doesn't have an author. But the next example that it gives has a group name. Okay, we've got that, Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. We've got a date. We've got a title of the page. It lists the site name, because sometimes the site where it's posted is different than the group that's posted it, and the URL address. So here's an example here, and you'll already see in their example that there's a difference. And note it says up here, if the author and site name are the same, omit the site name from the citation. So let's go look at ours now. Here this is split screen side by side so we can compare. All right, group name, we've got that, Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. It's all capitalized just like it is here. The date, August 3rd, 2021. Now that is different than the date that we saw here, updated February 25th, 2020. But what it's pulling from, and I think this is still okay, is at the very bottom of the page, it has a page last review, August 3rd, 2021. So that's the date it's pulling. I'm okay with that. I'm gonna stick with that. The next thing that the Purdue OWL list is the name of the website. And one thing I want to point out to you about this is, unlike MLA, in APA, the first letter of the article is capitalized, but the next first letters aren't, unless there's a colon. And if there's a colon here, like that little guy, the two little dots right there, the first word after the colon is capitalized, but the rest are not. So it actually did a good job on this, on the citation it grabbed, outbreak of lung injury associated with the use of e-cigarette or vaping products. Again, only outbreak is capitalized. Now it's got the same organization in here again. Remember, I don't need to list it twice. So let's go ahead and delete that because that doesn't need to be there. The retrieved date, which is actually optional, and you'll see here in some of the examples on Purdue OWL, they have it and some they don't. I'm gonna go ahead and leave it. It doesn't hurt anything to have it in there. And then finally my URL address. So this one looks okay, once it did a little bit of cleaning up. Now let me show you another example that I have pulled from a e-database. Here we are on the Galveston College website, and here's an article I like and I wanna use. So let's click on this article. And in most of these databases, you have the option of using their automatic citations. So over here on my right-hand column, I can click on the cite button. And it gives me options for different formats. I'm looking for APA 7th edition. All right, so I'm gonna just copy and paste this. All right, so let's paste this citation over here. Let me show you first of all, here is how it normally looks. And notice it's got this gray background behind it, which is really awful. Better yet, when you paste it, and you have to do this right at the time you paste it because it doesn't pop up quite as easily later on, you have paste options right here. See this little thing that's popped up? And if I choose that merge formatting, it fixes my font to match the font that's in the rest of my paper, and it also fixes that background. So the second little option right here, I'm gonna do that, and boom, that gray background is gone. It's hard to fix that gray background after that. I found that using the paint shading tool or the highlighting tool often doesn't fix it. So problem number one solved. We need to make sure that when we paste it, we choose the merge formatting. All right, problem number two. My authors look good. If there's fewer than 20 authors, then you don't need to do anything special. You just list each author, last name, comma, first initial. By the way, in APA, we only list the first initial because they're trying to get around gender bias, which is often a problem in publications and especially the sciences. And therefore, by using just the initials, it obscures gender and evens the playing field a little bit. Also, something that makes APA different from MLA is the year, the date of publication goes up towards the front because we're much more concerned with recency of publication. All right, remember I told you that in the article title, we need only the first letters to be capitalized. So we got to spend a little bit of time fixing this. So let me start. We're going to keep the capitalized, but let me start going through and fixing these. Then we've got a colon, and the A stays capitalized. So I'm going to lowercase all the letters after that. All right, fast forward, and I have done it. One thing I want to point out, though, is this last little part, United Arab Emirates. That is a country, and so therefore it's a proper noun, and all of it needs to be capitalized. All right, period at the end of the journal article. Then here's the journal title, Journal of Community Health. Each letter is capitalized in that except the of. Then we have got a comma, the volume, and the volume is italicized like the journal. But then right butted up against it is the number within the volume, the specific number of the publication. It's not italicized. And the citation generator got that right. We've got then the page numbers, and again, there's no P in front of the page numbers, just the range of pages that that citation came from. Even if you just used a quote on page 879, you still put the full range in your citation. In your document itself, you'll quote the specific page number, cite the specific page number 879. And then finally, we have the DOI address, which in electronic articles is a marker helping us permanently find that article abstract. So even if the web page changes, this DOI is permanent. A couple last things we need to do before we wrap this up. All right, first of all, I need to put these in alphabetical order. I only have two here, but B, the last name of that author, comes before C. So I'm going to cut and paste and move that up. And then let's get rid of these extra spaces in between. I need to have at the very top of my page references, because that's what we call it in APA, not works cited. And that word references is going to be centered. If I'm using my word headers or my word styles, I can do references like that. But again, I still need to take the time to center it. Last thing, and I don't know how that little guy got there. Last thing, we need to double space it. So I'm going to highlight everything. If I had a whole bunch of citations, I'd just highlight them all. I'm going to go up here under paragraph, and I'm going to select 2.0 to double space it. So there we go. Now my references look the way they're supposed to. So I hope that's helpful for you in cleaning up some of your citations that are created by citation generators. Thanks.